Hi, I'm Casey with Command Light, and today I'm going to be showing you how to change out your lower actuator on the Knight 2. The tools you're going to need are a ball peen hammer, some kind of small punch or pin, a 3/8 nut driver, a 3/4 inch wrench, a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, a small flat bladed screwdriver, needle nose pliers, side cutters, and some kind of wire strippers. You'll also need a new 6-inch bare linear lower actuator. So when you're ready to start changing your actuator, you'll want to bring your tower up all the way. Use either some kind of tie down or ratchet strap to bring this lift arm as far forward as possible. You do want to have a little bit of play in this. You don't want it to be too tight. When you're putting this actuator back in, to get the holes in the actuator and the lift arm to line up just right, you may have to move this back and forth just slightly, but just make sure that this is tied up so that when you remove this, it's not going to fall down on you. Once you get it up and tied down, you'll go through and remove all the screws on your relay box cover lid. I've already done that. You can remove the lid. You'll use your 3/8 nut driver to remove the relay board. There's a nut under each side of the board. Once you get the relay board removed, you're going to have a white pull strip down in the bottom of the box here. You're going to remove your actuator wires. They are gray and black. Gray is in pole number 7 and black is in pole number 8. Just use your small flat bladed screwdriver to loosen those screws up. Go ahead and remove those two wires. On the back side of the relay box, there's going to be a small 3/8 seal con. You'll use your 3/4 inch open end wrench to loosen that up. I've already done that. You'll remove the E-clip on this side of the tower so we can remove this pin. Carefully tap this pin out. Be careful at this point because you are taking your actuator out and the only thing holding this tower up is the strap. Once you've removed the upper pin, then you can go ahead and remove the lower pin. You'll take out the E-clip on this side. Then we'll push that pin through. And remove the actuator. When you get your new actuator, you're going to want to run the pin all the way out in the actuator. You can do that manually by using a screwdriver. And just spin until it hits its limit. You might have to spin it back around just a hair, just to line the holes up. You can also do that with a battery. You'll hook positive up to gray and your ground up to black. Then we're ready to pop this actuator in. We'll set the actuator in place here and start with the lower pin first, popping it in from this side. Get that pin all the way through. and then replace your E-clip. So at this point, when you're putting your upper pin back in, you may have to loosen your strap just a hair. You may have to move this back and forth just a little bit to get the holes in the actuator and the holes in the lift arm to line up. I just got mine to line up. I'm gonna go ahead and start getting that through. As you get that most of the way through, you wanna check on the other side and see where your pin is and see if it's lining up. This one, the pin is too high, so I need to rotate my actuator this way. I might have to put some pressure on that as I'm tapping it in to get that pin to line up so it doesn't pop my bushing out. Then once your pin is all the way through, go ahead and put your E-clip back on. Make sure that's on there nice and tight. Your actuator is now in. We can go ahead and run the wires back into the relay box. Make sure you're routing this around all these cables in this direction, going through the small seal con. Just make sure you leave a nice little loop here, a little extra, so when this goes up and down, it doesn't ever pull too tight. So you get that wire in the right spot, go ahead and tighten down that seal con. You'll use that 3/4 inch wrench to get that nice and tight. Once you get that tight, you can wire in the actuator. Again, your gray is going to go to position number 7, which has red black on the opposite side, and your black will go to position number 8, and that will have orange black on the opposite side. Once you get your wires in the pull strip there, just tug on them a little bit, make sure their connections are good. Just fold that gray and black wire back, and then we'll go ahead and put our relay board back on. Use that 3/8 nut driver to tighten the nuts back down. Once you get the board nice and tight on there, you can go ahead and replace your relay box cover. Screw down all the screws, make sure those are all nice and tight, and your lower actuator is replaced. If you have any questions, you can visit our website or give us a call. This has been Casey with Command Light. Thanks for watching.